Lord, everybody. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Say praise the Lord. Say hallelujah. This is a day that the Lord has made. I want to rejoice and be glad in it. Today deemed a very special day in the lives of the couples. And so I'm going to ask the couples to please take your stand right here. Once you're a couple in the house, change your position and come on up and sit in the middle. I'm going to do a little shifting here, please. Please work with me. All highlight, and not that you're left out, you know. You are the audience and we are the guests. You agree with me? All right, so I want you to feel special just the same. So the couples are going to sit in the middle. If you are in the house, your husband is not here, please come and sit on my right. Come on, if your husband is not here, that's fine. If your husband is here, sit together. If you're married, your husband is not here, change your position, come up to my right. And those who, yeah, if you are here and you're married, your spouse has deceased, please sit over here. Move gracefully and move with a praise. If you're married, your husband is not in church with you today, please sit over this side. You're married and your husband is here with you, sit in the middle. If you're married and your husband is deceased, sit over this side. And I ask the audience to come up in the back section. The first half, yes. Beautiful, I love that. Thank you. Come on up, come on up. Now you're sitting too far. Once you are married and your husband is not in church with you, but you are here, you're on my right, my left. Am I correct? Right. Yes. Yeah. Beautiful. Every married couple should be sitting with your spouse. Beautiful. Brother Malahu,
hello.
Just change your position and you're too far. Too far. Come on over and make it find a comfortable seat. The bench is a little uncomfortable for Brother Malahu, we understand. But if you want a chair or some, come on up a little, but you're too far. Beautiful. Thank you for your kind cooperation. All right. Looking great. Looking great. Put your hands and give yourself a round of applause. Clap yourselves. Yes, we must look like church, and we are having church. And I want you to forget about home, forget about the ailment, whatever it is, and just put God in the midst of everything. What if you understand me? Yeah, don't concentrate on the pain or whatever, but put God in the midst and the center of it. Beautiful. Now, I have my co-host, my one and only, my friend, my confidant, my everything, all in all, me left and me right and me everything. I can't do nothing without this person. He filled my life with all the beauty and sparkle and the splendor that God created. And I'm speaking of Mr. Stephen Antonio Bowen. Put your hands together and make the man of my life welcome. All right.
Hallelujah.
We have myself and Sister Mala, who is a president for the couples ministry. But best of all, we have the man of the hour, the host pastor, the bishop of the Glendevon New Testament Church of God District. He and his, he will tell you, may not get into that. But welcome, Mr. and Mrs. Lewis. Pleasure to have you both. At this time, you don't say Mr. and Pastor. We know some of the Reverend and the Bishop. But welcome Mr. and Mrs. Lewis in the house. Put your hands together for the lovely couple. Beautiful. All right. Can I ask the couples now to stand for me, please? All the couples, grab your partner and just go out the door for me, please, and thank you. And I have a selection. And so everybody's seated. Remember, you're the bride for the dinner. They come to wedding. Yes. We are at wedding, so you're going to put on the wedding march and the wedding look and the style. And if the pain is in the knee, you're going to help your spouse. You're going to help whosoever have the pain. And we're going to do it together. You agree with me? All right. Love in the house. What are we talking about? Love is a flag flowing high from the... While you're selecting the song, that's not the marching song, you know. From the castle of my heart, love is a flag flowing high from the castle of my heart. And the king is the resident here. So fly it high in the... Let the whole world... Oh, let the whole world, oh, let the whole world. Oh, and the king. I from the castle of my heart, from the castle of my heart. Spell with me, L, O, D, E, what does that say? Love. Love. Say that again. Love. Love. I love you.
I love you.
All right. So the selection is now on. The couples are going to make them way in.
Love is true. Or minute have I had
Sorry. No, they could have gone. Wait. Come on. It is all for you. Man. We could have marched, but we are gonna. I know. Alrighty. All right, here we are now. Your time, Mr. Musician. So you have the entrance of Mr. and Mrs. Lewis. Burn. Mr. and Mrs.
Love has truly been good to
Mr. and Mrs.
Rose. Not even one second or minute have I had since you've come my way.
Mr. and Mrs. Rose.
You know
Mr. and Mrs. Rose. Come on, keep the chair going.
Anywhere you take me, it's so to be loved, I follow you.
Mr. and Mrs. Benny, thank you. Mr. and Mrs. Williams.
To the moon and the sky above.
Give it up for the couples. Beautiful, beautiful. So amazing to be loved. Follow you to the moon.
And it's so amazing to be loved. I could stay forever. Here in love and believe you never. Cause we've got amazing love. Truly.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I appreciate it. Put your hands together. Beautiful, beautiful. You may be seated. Thank you very much. And at this time, without any further ado, we're going to have the opening prayer done by Mr. and Mrs. Leslie. Put your hands together for them. Okay, all decked in red and white, looking beautifully decked out. Put your hands together as he allowed his wife to make entry. All right.
Morning, brothers and sister. Morning, brothers and sister.
Morning.
All right. I'm here to introduce my beautiful wife.
Of course.
Sugar Plum Plum.
Take your time.
Apple of my eyes.
Love it.
She's just everything to me, you can think.
Talk of the things.
Yeah. Without she, my life is, you understand? She's my motivator.
Beautiful.
She's my strength after. She's just about everything, as I said. Amen. I'm introducing her to do the open prayer for this morning. All right?
Thank you, Brother Leslie. Thank you, honey. Nice. Okay.
Nice.
Shall we bless the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
A man of many words, not because he looks simple, but trust me, Brother Leslie, come out strong. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Shall we bless the Lord? It's prayer time. Let us bow our heads in prayer this morning. And for the couples this morning, just hold a hand or put your hands around your partner, whatever. But just do something together in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Our Father and our God, as we come before you this morning, God, to give you thanks, to give you praise, and to give you honor, and to give you glory. Father God, we thank you, God, this morning, that we are in your presence this morning. Father God, to lift up your holy name, because you are God.
Hallelujah.
And this morning, as we come this morning, a special service, Father God, it's a special service, my God, for marriage couple this morning.
Yes,
and as we come, mighty God, we ask God this morning to intervene.
In
we ask God
Jesus.
This morning to cover us under your holy blood. We ask this morning, God Almighty, that you will keep us from all danger and from all harm. God, we pray, God, this morning for each and every one, mighty God, in the sanctuary. We pray, God Almighty, your protection this morning. We pray, God Almighty, that there be unity and that there be love, mighty God, in our marriages this morning.
Yes,
we pray, God, for happiness. We pray, God, for peace.
Yes.
We pray, God Almighty, that, mighty God, nothing, mighty God, will come between a couple, because you say what God has joined together
this morning.
Let
Hallelujah.
No man put us under. So we come, God Almighty,
God.
And we cast on everything this morning. Father God, there will be no other one but a couple. Father God, we pray, mighty
in
God,
the
that
name
they
of
decide.
Jesus.
We stay on the side.
In the
and
name
we pray
of
that,
Jesus.
Mighty God, anything that is burning,
in
we
the
continue
name
to
of
burn
Jesus.
It. And we pray, God Almighty, that
Hallelujah.
No home wrecker will come in and
the
wreck this family.
Jesus.
Because we are joined together this morning
in
oneness and in unity and in love, mighty God.
Yes, Lord.
We pray, God Almighty, that marriage will go from strength to strength this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We pray, God Almighty, that you will keep us in all our way, in the ways this morning. We pray, God Almighty, for strength this morning. We pray, God Almighty, unity this morning. Father God, we lift up your holy name this morning. And we tell you thanks for goodness. We tell you thanks, God, for mercy. We tell you thanks, God, for protection. We tell you thanks, God, for love.
Thank
we tell
you
thanks,
Jesus.
God, that we have been alive this morning.
You,
it's
Jesus.
A beautiful day.
Thank
it's
you,
a
Lord.
New day
Hallelujah.
In our
world.
It is a
Glory
new day.
Hallelujah.
And so, Father, we give you thanks this morning for this day. Hallelujah. We lift up your holy name this morning.
Oh,
for the moderators. And we pray, God Almighty, for your anointing this morning. We pray, God Almighty, for every word that we said this morning. Your name will be glorified this morning. We thank you, God Almighty, for today's speaker. We thank you, God Almighty, for each and every one. We pray, God Almighty, the word that come this morning, mighty God, it will help us, mighty God, to grow stronger in our marriage. Because, mighty God, there is a word this morning. And we believe, mighty God, that things will be changed this morning. Situation, mighty God, circumstances will be changed this morning. Father God, we thank you, God Almighty, for every each and every one this morning. We pray, God Almighty, for those who are coming. We ask you, God, for journeying mercy. And we ask you, God, for protection throughout this service. Your blood, mighty God, your anointing this morning will be upon us. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We continue to worship the Lord.
The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. When we pray, we believe that God hears and he answers prayer. In the same trend of worship, I'm going to ask you to stand again as we'll be invited, Brother and Sister Malawu, as they will be doing for us the devotional exercise.
Pleasant morning, everyone. Morning. To God be the glory, great things he has done. Amen. We are this morning the Malawus, and we are here, as in Malawu, we are East Indian mangoes. And we are here to glorify God and to enjoy the fruit that God has blessed us with.
Amen.
Praise God. We are here to do the devotional exercise. And I'm going to ask you, please, to turn with me to Ephesians chapter 5, from verses 22 to 33. You are going to follow in your Bibles and listen while we read. Bless the Lord. Ephesians 5, 22 to 33.
Good morning. Are we all ready? Okay. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord.
For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body.
Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything.
Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it,
that he might sanctify it and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word,
that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such things, but that it should be holy and without blemish.
So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself.
For no man ever yet ate his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord, the church. Could you please read that verse for me, Brother Malahu? Verse 29. Please read it for me.
For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord, the church.
Wonderful. Your next verse.
For we are members of his body, of his flesh and of his bones.
For this cause shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh.
This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church.
Verse 33, and last, we are going to do it together. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife sees that he reverence her husband. Again, we are going to read it again, brethren. Hallelujah. Verse 33. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Hallelujah. Here endeth a portion of the holy word of the Almighty God. We'll honor it by saying amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We are going to turn to those who have their program. Please, look, the song is there. If you do not have a program, turn to your church hymnal, 265 from the church hymnal. And we are going to sing to the honor and the glory of the Almighty God.
I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more.
But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From the waters lifted me, now save his will obey.
saved
today. Love lifted me. Oh, love lifted me. When my feet has gone down, love lifted me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. When nothing else could help. We're talking about the love of God now. Yes, love so mighty and so pure. The love of God is greater far than the tongue or pen can ever tell. And if ever we're going to make it in the marriage, we have to have Jesus love. We have to have the gapy love. We have to have God's love within our heart. Because God knows no bitterness. God knows no distance. God knows nothing that will allow me to be offended. He's just a lover man. And so when we come together as couples, love must lift us. Eh? Love, beautiful song. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Hello. Sister and Brother Leslie, for doing the opening prayer. Thank you, Brother and Sister Malahu, Mr. and Mrs. Malahu, for doing the morning devotion thus far. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. Praise the Lord. We're moving into the welcome and day's announcement. This will be done by Mr. and Mrs. Green, Brother and Sister Green. Put your hands together and let them feel welcome.
Bless the Lord. You'll be only seeing Mrs. Green this morning, because Mr. Green is in the control room by himself. So is Mrs. Green alone this morning. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. Shall we give a wave offering to the Father this morning, to the Son, and to the blessed Holy Trinity? Bless the Lord. To all the wonderful couples that are here this morning, you're looking wonderful. Watch out, Mr. Freite, I look for me. Yes, Mr. Freite, I look good. We also want to welcome our host pastor, Bishop James Lewis and Sister Lewis. Welcome to our day's moderators, the Bowens, and the praise team, our ushers on duty for today, and our wonderful couples. Please stand, all the couples that are here today. It is indeed Couples Sunday. So couples, please stand. Put your hands together for all the couples. I don't know who had to force somebody to come this morning, but I want to see the wives giving their husbands a big troops this morning. Yes. Troops. Yes. Praise the Lord. I'm not sure, husbands, are you satisfied with the troops? The congregation answering for no. All right, we don't have to do it again, wives. They're never satisfied. Devona, they're not satisfied. Me not satisfied. Praise the Lord. That's right. Amen. You can be seated. Praise the Lord. To all the wonderful brethren who came out for this special service, don't feel excluded. Don't feel jealous. For those who didn't get their husbands or their wives to come today, don't feel bad. We understand. All right? So for those who are viewing online, we thank you for tuning in this morning to our couples service and couples Sunday service. And we trust that you'll have a good one with us today. So continue to enjoy the rest of the day's proceedings and just have your cups turned up for whatever is going to be poured into it today. And I trust that you will leave here receiving something good. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We want to specially welcome Mr. and Mrs. Sydney Bennett. Please stand. Put your hands together for them. Praise the Lord. All right. We also have Sister Nelson's daughter here with us today, Miss Keisha McLean. Please stand, Keisha. I was standing up here looking at her and I said, that looked like Keisha. Good to have you. Good to have you. I don't know if you remember, she's the one who lost her son over in America the other day. We ask that you continue to remember her in prayer. All right? Praise the Lord. These are the day's announcements. This month, our denomination is focusing on building strong marriages. And as of such, you see, today is our Couples Sunday. Fasting service will be on Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. right here. There'll be no Bible study this Wednesday evening, as we all know that it will be Ash Wednesday, and it will be also the Cornwall Women's Gathering, and it will be at the Westgate Hills Baptist Church, and it starts at 9 a.m. And you can make your way over there. I don't think you'll have a seat challenge this year. Hopefully not. But you can go on over and support the Women's Convention. Singles Ministry Sip and Paint will be this Friday, February 16, and it starts at 6:30 p.m. right here in the sanctuary. All singles, please come on out for this. National Musicians Conference will be on February 24 at the Mandeville Church. Please indicate if you're interested in attending. February 25 is Water Baptism Sunday. All candidates for baptism, you're asked to prepare for that Sunday. Youth Congress will be April 4 to 6 at the Convention Center in Old Harbor. We would like to arrange transportation early, so please indicate if you're going as soon as possible. Sister Hortense Ricketts is out of the hospital, and we ask that the church continue to remember her in prayer. Sister Sheba Ferron is also requesting special prayer. We ask that you remember her in prayer as well. Happy birthday greetings are going out to all those who will be celebrating throughout this week. And we have Sister Lucille Reynolds right down there in her blue. She'll be celebrating her 99th birthday tomorrow. Please stand, Sister Reynolds. Right, Sister Reynolds, please stand. All right. We have Brother Leon Brown, who will be celebrating his tomorrow also. And we have Sister Mita Daly, who celebrates hers on Tuesday. All right. So, do we have any anniversary celebrants for this week? Anybody celebrating anniversary throughout this week or any other birthdays? Sister Sonia. The 7th, last week. Oh, you never did your last week. I'm going to wish you a happy birthday, not true. That's right. You did watch it online. You know, sister, me wish you happy birthday last week. All right, so we trust that you had a good one, though. All right, the worship team is going to come, and they're going to do the birthday song for all those who are celebrating throughout this week.
Happy birthday to you. This is your day. You know that we love you in a very special way. This is your day, your day. Happy birthday to you. But a number, don't you stop having fun. This is your day, happy birthday to you.
Praise the Lord. We trust that you live to see many, many more as you celebrate your special days. I also want to welcome back Sister Amelia Williams, who did surgery the other day. Welcome back, Sister Amelia. Good to see you. Praise the Lord. I leave with the couples today, the marriage box. Most people get married believing a myth that marriage is a beautiful box full of all the things they have longed for, companionship, intimacy, friendship, etc. The truth is that marriage at start is an empty box. You must put something in before you can take anything out. There is no love in marriage. Love is in people. And to people put into marriage. There is no romance in marriage. People have to infuse it into their marriages. A couple must learn the art and form the habit of giving, loving, serving, praising, keeping the box full. If you take out more than you put in, the box will be empty. So, for the rest of us who are not married, I leave with you. Sometimes we lose ourselves for a while, and that's okay. It's all a part of learning. Just make sure your comeback is stronger than your setback. The Lord bless you.
Thank you, Sister Green.
Those were the day's announcement. Hope that you will bear them in mind and go accordingly. We are about to go into our theme, motto, and pledge. But let me say something before. Proverbs 18 verses 22 states, "He who finds a wife findeth a good thing and obtain favor from the Lord. And indeed, the Lord has favored me. He has blessed me with this beautiful lady beside me, Diana Bowen. She's my rose. She's my everything. She talks about me earlier, but it's my time now to talk. I love you. You are special. And thank you for being a part of my life. In your eyes, I can see my dream's reflection. In your eyes, I found the answers to my question. In your eyes, I can see the reason why our love's alive. in your eyes. We're drifting safely back to shore, and I think I've finally learned to love you more.
Woo. Amen. That one connect. I love it, I love it, I love it. Yes, man, yes, man. And you know what? You know we belong together. You and I forever and ever. No matter where you are, you're my guiding star. Catch it right there. All right, I'm going to ask you, please. I have asked to put it on the monitor, the pledge motto on the theme song. Please do, thanks. And so I'm going to ask you just, you can sit. And, well, it would be only the couple, so I want everybody to be engaged. So you can just gaze over to the monitor wherever you are, and we do it together. And so we begin with our motto. Say motto, everybody.
Motto.
Songs of Solomon 1, verse 15. Behold, thou art fair, my love. Behold, thou art fair. Thou hast dove eyes. Wow. Now turn to your spouse and the audience. Listen. Okay. Begin now, couples. 1, 2, 3.
Motto.
Songs of Solomon 1, verse 15.
Behold, thou art fair, my love. Behold, thou art fair, thou hast dove eyes.
Do you see the dove in the eyes there? Whoa, wow. And we move now to the pledge. All right, there goes our pledge. Everybody, pledge. I pledge to love, honor, and cherish you till death do us part. Sorry about that. Let's do it all over again.
Pledge, I pledge to love, honor, and cherish you till death do us part.
Amen. Till death do us part. And for those who on this side, you know me talk about love, don't it? You have lost a spouse, but remember those memories. Memories, you live with the memories of the good time. You are not disconnected, you still connect. Okay, you know what? You are still a bride. Amen. Don't it? You have the privilege to be a bride. You are a bride. Amen. Beautiful. And so we move over now to the theme song. And so we sing along. I don't know if you know it. If you don't, just listen and then we catch it the second and the third time and we move on. Love in any language, straight from the heart, put us all together, never apart. And once you learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, fluently spoken here. Love in any language, straight from the heart. Put us all together, never apart. And once you learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in every language, fluently spoken. Can we do it one more time, everybody?
Love in every language, straight from the heart. Put us all together, never apart. To speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, fluently
is spoken here.
Do you believe that? Do you believe that love in any language? So if you whisper to your spouse, if you touch your spouse, if you give him a token, whatever, it comes in different languages. Speaking about what? Love. And once we have it, it will show.
Yes.
Once we have the love, it will show.
Hallelujah. Once you have it, it will show. And the lifestyle you live, it tells a lot. Persons look up to you. You set examples before them. And like how Diane come up here and talk about me, that's how we are living. It's no fake. We don't come up here and, you know, like it's fake, but it is not fake because we are living our life together in Christ. So we can boast about each other. Anywhere we go, we can stand and say, okay, this is it.
Then.
Because we are living a life
then.
That is pleasing before God.
Big up yourself.
Big up. Big up.
Amen. Amen. All right. Can I ask everybody please to stand as we give up some praise to the lover of all lover, the giver of all good love, the giver of all good gifts, which is Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, beloved, though we are the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what it shall be, but we know when he shall appear. But we know when he shall appear, we shall be like him. We shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Come on, sing the song, long time, old time song. Beloved, beloved, though we are the sons of God, and he does not yet appear what he shall be. But we know when he shall appear. Does not yet appear what he shall be, but we know when he shall appear. But we know, yeah, yeah, he shall appear. We shall be like him. We shall be. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Oh, I say yes,
yes,
Lord, yes, yes,
to your will.
To your will and to your way.
Oh,
I say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks, with my own heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes.
That's why it's commitment. I say yes, Lord,
yes, Lord, from the bottom of my heart to the depth of my soul, yes, Lord,
yeah, yeah.
Completely.
Yes,
my soul, say yes. from the bottom of to the depth and to the depth of my soul. Yes, Lord.
Completely,
yes. My soul. Say yes.
I love you, Lord. I love you.
From the bottom of my heart
to the depth and
to the depth of my soul, I love you.
I love you. Say,
I really do. My soul, say yes.
That's right, I say yes. I say yes,
Lord. Yes,
yes, Lord.
To your will, to your will. Yes,
yes,
oh yes,
I
will trust you and the blood. Your spirit speaks to me.
You in my whole
heart, I'll
agree.
And my answer will be
yes,
Lord, yes.
I say yes, Lord.
I say yes,
yes,
Lord,
yes, yes.
To your will,
to your will,
to your will.
My soul
says yes. Lord, yes,
yeah.
I will trust
when
your spirit
speaks
to me,
Lord,
with my whole heart I'll agree,
and
my answer will be yes, Lord, yes,
I love you.
To the depths of
I love you. I really do, yes, Lord.
I really do.
My soul say yes.
My soul.
I wanna love it one more time. Say yay.
I love you.
I love you.
Yeah.
From the bottom of my heart to the depths of
to the depths.
My soul.
I love you.
I really do.
I really do. My soul say yes.
Can we love the Lord this morning? Can we love him this morning? Oh, we love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. We give you praise. We lift your name on our head this morning. You are the greatest giver of all good gifts. You are the Son of the Most High God. You are the wheel in the middle of the wheel. You are the bridge over troubled water. You are the comforter. Hallelujah. You are the peace in the midst of every storm. We love you this morning. We worship you, Jehovah. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be exalted. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my
I'm
life.
I'm so glad, I'm so glad.
And I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from
heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My day you paid from the cross to the grave. From the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name.
I'm so glad you're in my life, Lord.
I'm so glad you're in my life. came to save.
From heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my death you pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Take it down, take it down. Hallelujah.
Lord, I love to sing
praises unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah.
I'm so glad.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Hallelujah.
I'm so glad you came to save.
Thank God, yes.
You came from heaven to earth to show. Cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name,
God, I lift up your name, Jehovah, oh, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shekinah, Jehovah, hallelujah, we lift your name above all this morning, we worship you, Jehovah. Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, peace. Thank you, hope. Thank you, Lord. You deserve the praises. You deserve the glory. You deserve the honor. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth. Hallelujah to all generation. This moment is yours, God. Now and forever, we worship you, we give you praise, we exalt you, we thank you, Lord, for waking us up this morning. We thank you, Lord, for the bread that is blown our bodies, as we come as a collected form, as we come as one to worship you, Lord. You deserve the glory. Hallelujah. You deserve the glory, God. Hallelujah.
The glory and the honor
as we lift our hearts in worship
and we to praise your holy name.
Hallelujah. You deserve the glory, God,
and the honor as we lift our hearts in worship as we praise your holy name. You are great, you're a miracle so great, and there is no one else like you. There is no one else like you, for you are
above your heads and magnify the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. There is none like you, Lord. Oh, you do miracles so great. You are awesome. Oh, we worship you this morning. Oh, excellent is your name this morning. Oh, great the Lord. You are great. Oh, you are awesome. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Please stand, everybody. Get your offering and what you have to give to the Lord. And I'm going to invite Mr. and Mrs. Rowe. Brother and sister, Mr. and Mrs. Rowe, to come and bless the morning tides.
And before day comes, Sister Weatherburn and Brother Weatherburn, so she would like to say something to the couples. So I'm going to give them the opportunity to say before we go off to collecting of the tithes and offering. Sister Weatherburn and Brother Weatherburn.
While the ushers, you can get yourself together. Please stand.
Pleasant good morning.
Good morning.
Sister Beverly Weatherburn, isn't she look splendorous? Beverly Weatherburn, is it she look splendorous, brethren?
Yes, babe.
Okay. She is the lover of my life. I just want to say it publicly, that if I have a choice to get married, I have no regret marrying this lady again.
Amen.
At this time, she'll say something.
Pleasant good morning. When I say these words, if you agree with me, you say, wow. We need to give our spouse attention.
Wow.
We need to admire our spouse.
Wow.
We need to adore our spouse.
Wow.
Be in bed.
Wow.
With their belly.
Wow.
And with their back.
Wow.
We need to care for our spouses.
Wow.
I didn't hear that one.
Wow.
We need to caress our spouses.
Wow.
And we need to commend our spouses.
Wow.
And we need, when this one don't refer to you, you say no. We need not to condemn our spouses.
No.
And we need not to compare our spouses.
No.
And this one you say, wow. We need to be devoted.
Wow.
We need to be dynamic.
Wow.
And we need to be disciplined.
Wow.
God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. So the moment of the day is wow. Love it. Beautiful, beautiful. And wow.
Shall we bless the Lord? Shall we bless the Lord another time? Praise the Lord. God has been so good to us. We have to lead from the front. When God has blessed you with someone special in your life, you just hold him and say, our love was meant to be. A kind of love will last forever. Lord bless you. Lord bless you. We are here to do the tithes and offering. Tithes and offering is the only investment that lasts forever. When we give in faith, trusting totally in God, even when we are in need, his miraculous provision began to come our way. Giving tithes and offering put our love for God before our worldly wealth, and show that our heart is always with him.
Wow.
Blessing. Wow. All right. This morning, I'm here to bless the tithes and offering. But before I do that, this lady beside me, I've been through some rough time just to get her. But through it all, the songwriter say, when you find a virtuous woman, yes, you find a good thing.
Amen.
Eddie Fitzroy, I think, sing this song about Princess Black.
Yes.
She is my Princess Black. So I just want to bless up all the couples and all the singles one day,
yes,
as I go through rough times, but I'm here,
yes,
rejoicing with my Princess Black.
Oh.
So I'm going to do that prayer now. Father, we give you thanks, mighty God. We ask, Lord, for your journey mercies, God. As we journey here, God, to worship you with our tithes and offering, mighty God, we thank you, Lord, for those who gave, Lord, and those who don't even have to give, God, because of circumstances. God, we pray that in due time they will, Lord. So we ask, Lord, that you will bless, sanctify, oh God, the tithes and offering, that God, it will use, mighty God, to build the kingdom, God. And I pray, God, no demon, no weapon from hell will ever deal around this tithes and offering, mighty God, but it will go to the benefit of your kingdom. Thank you, mighty God, for your Holy Spirit. As we leave everything completely in your hand, in your care, we tell you thanks in Jesus' name.
Wow. All right, as the usher will indicate and give it a directive, we are going up. We're going up together. We're going up to conquer in the name of the Lord. Yes,
we are going up. We're going up together. We're going up to conquer in the name of the Lord. I am a warrior. I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer in the name of the Lord. I am a warrior. I am a conqueror. In the name of the Lord. So we are going up together. In the name of the Lord.
I am a warrior. I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord.
I am a warrior. I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord, Delta, no, no, don't defeat to me. I am a child of God, and I've got the victory.
Hey, hey, hey,
Delta, no, no, don't defeat to me. I am a child of God, and I've had the victory.
We are going up.
We're going up together. We're going up to conquer. In the name of
we are going up together.
We are going, we are going. We're going up together. We're going up to conquer
in the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord.
Victory.
Victory.
and the God of victory.
We are going up one of these
days. We are going, we are going. We're going up together. We're going up to conquer. In the name of the Lord. We are going up, 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 up. We're going up together. We're going up to conquer. In the name of the Lord,
I am a warrior. I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord,
I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord,
I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord,
I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord,
I am a warrior.
I am a conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of the Lord,
I'm an overcomer.
In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Indeed, glory to God. In the name of the Lord. Don't talk to me. Don't talk to me. We are conquerors in the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You have been good. Our next item, we have an item on the program. Will be done by Mr. and Mistress Cox. But before they comes with their special item, I was told that Brother Minot is here, is in the house.
Wow, put your hands together.
I know he cannot stand, but his wife will represent him.
Beautiful.
Standing up.
Welcome.
Brother Minot. Thank you, Sister Minot.
Beautiful.
To God be
beautiful.
The glory. He's here, and we give thanks.
Beautiful.
We give
welcome.
Praise. Could I ask the coppers to come?
And I learned that Brother and Sister Reed, that Sister Mary's husband, is in the house. Come on, welcome, welcome, sir, welcome. Sir Reed, why are you so far? You're disattached, brother. Come up here, sir, brother. Your seat is up here, sir. And I also have my sister in the house,
yes,
Barbara. Put your hands together for Mrs. Hines. Thank you for coming,
cheering
today. And if I missed you, I did not mean to, but I'll get you another time. And we say, wow.
Wow.
Good morning, saints of God. It's indeed a happy moment for us to be in Couples Week. It's my first time being in a setting like this, and I'm giving God all the glory. I am on the theme of vows. I will give you a little story about vows. The first time I answered to the marriage vows, which is traditionally done by married couples, and a month later I went to another wedding which my friend was getting married, and when I sit and I listened to the vow at that time, I panicked. I did not even realize what I answered to before, a month before. Believe me, I thought the vows was a death sentence. The next time that I hear them, oh my God, it was like frightening. But today I am like 2 years and almost 3 months in my marriage. And I just want to say to my husband that our vows is of utmost importance. And I just want to remind him that no matter what, I will, with the help of God, rather, I'll never break them. Amen. From the moment I met you. You make my life complete. The web of pure devotion still swept me off my feet. And that night when we kissed, it still took my breath away. But it goes without saying, but I'll say it anyways. Those vows go on broken, and you still know I do. Love, keep, and honor, always true to you. Though I have been tempted, though I have never strayed, I die before I damage this union we have made. The vows go on broken, and you still know I do. Love, keep, and honor.
Wow.
Wow. Always true.
Oh, wow. Wow.
Wow. I have been tempted, though I have never strayed, I die before I damage this union we have made.
Hallelujah. Wow.
When we, you still took my breath away. It goes without saying, but I'll say it anyways. The vows go on broken, but you still know I do. Love, keep, and honor, always true to you. I'll say in closing that to the couples here and in the wider world, listen, marriage life is not easy. I can tell you that. Especially when you're trying to serve Almighty God. It is a challenge. It is a task. And I mean a great task. You won't even understand. But God knows everything. So love your spouse, no matter what the circumstances may be. They might not always agree with you, because I am the miserable one. Me are the one will love war. My husband that say, you love war, you know. But he's the most reserved one, quiet. And I can tell you, when I look at his humility, I look at how he's humbled. This is the things that really draws me to him, because I always love a humble man. And if I don't mind, me have to say to him, answer me now, answer me. It's like, no, him not answer, him not retaliate, him not look for me. So you feel like you're alone in this war. But listen to me, when you get a humble man, it means everything. You understand? And Mr. Cox, I love you. To be honest, I really do.
Wow.
Well, so far, no. As a true and nothing but true, you know. Me love her the same
That's
way,
all
right. Always. Yeah, she's always there for me, no matter what. Yeah, from a meet her, it's just a blessing, you know. Everything just happened the right way, the right time. Everything I work out, you know. Yeah, so she is mine and always be mine, you know. In Jesus' name.
Thank you. I love it. How you feeling down there? How you feeling? Beautiful. To be honest, I want to endorse it. Whatever you see happening here today, it's real. It's nice to be in love. Oh, glory to God. Just give God some praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Marriage, some people think that marriage now we're. Marriage is just for style. No style. God instituted marriage. And so sometimes we take it for puppet. Sometimes we take it, belittle it. But to be honest, you know, I always said I am blessed to be a bride. I am honored to be a bride. And it's a wow.
Wow.
Mr. Bowen.
Wow. God is good, brethren. God is good.
Praise
and,
God.
And Diane and I met. I remember one Friday night, I came to Youth Fellowship. And the program that they were having, getting to know each other. And I was sitting on the second half there in a green and black shirt. And the moderator said, Diana, I want you to get to know that gentleman in the green and black shirt. I looked over my shoulder and I said, but wait, I'm alone in a green and black, you know. And I don't know who Diane was, but I saw this brown lady coming. And there we shared, and you know, she said, my favorite, what is my favorite color, food, that, and I did not know that she would be my wife. She did not know, because we weren't, say, looking, you know, I wasn't looking for a wife, she wasn't looking for, yes, we know we have that in mind, that in life we want a wife and a husband, but that, not at that moment, we weren't, you know, looking, and God is so good. God has tied the both of us together. And here we are, what we are, 29 years this year. December will be 30 years together. And we have to give God the glory,
God.
The honor, and the praise. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I did not say nothing more, but wow. Beautiful, like beautiful. What a moment. Yes. What a time to put on the speaker. This beautiful wow moment in our audience. I don't need to do any too much introduction. The first lady, the woman of the ladies of Glendevon, the wife of Reverend Lewis. Ah, and me no want to say nothing more, but he will say the rest. And so when he comes, just get your notepads. Yes, and receive all that you can. And not only listen to them, let's put them into action. Let's live the life and let the life speak for you. It's my privilege to give you Jacqueline Lewis.
Rev.
And I will always love you.
Yes.
Well, I am not a good singer. But I want you to know that I am a proud husband today.
Yes.
To have such a wonderful, beautiful, charming,
yes,
and loving wife beside me. And I will always love her and cherish her. It is her moment. I am going to allow her to speak. And afterward,
yes,
I will come back and do the rest. Put your hands
right
together for her.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Don't make me cry, man. Sure. Wow. Okay, greetings, everybody. Amen. Special greetings to my one and only. My milk in my coffee. My milk in my porridge. And I will cut it right there. But Rev, I love you and thank you for being there. 38 years.
Wow. Say it again.
Praise the Lord. Wow. God has been good. And I just want to greet you all in the name of Jesus. It is a special day. A day when we celebrate love. A day when we celebrate what God has given us. So let me just greet the moderator. I want to greet the officers, everyone. Greetings in the name of Jesus. I will not be long, and today is not one of those days that will be running the aisle. I will just be sharing with you today. And you know, listening to you, sitting there and listening to the couples expressing themselves, it is such a joy to hear you. It is such a joy. And the devil don't like that, you know. That's why you don't love that. But guess what? We give him a knockout punch. Every time we give him a knockout punch. And today is one of those days that we are going to lick him for six. Amen? Amen. So God bless you. The topic I was given was for better, for worst. I was asked to share on that. And so I added a sub-theme, which I just wrote, commitment. So the topic, better for worse, and I will focus a little on commitment. There's a scripture that I would love to share about three verses from, and that is 1 Samuel chapter 1. I'll be reading from verse 4 to 8. And when the time was that Elkanah offered, he gave to Peninnah his wife, to all her sons and her daughters, portions. But unto Hannah he gave a worthy portion, for he loved Hannah. But the Lord had shut her womb. And her adversary also provoked her sore, for to make her fret, because the Lord had shut her womb. Verse 7, and as he did so year by year, when she went up to the house of the Lord, so she provoked her, therefore she wept and did not eat. Verse 8, then said Elkanah, her husband, to her, Hannah, why weepest thou? And why eatest thou not? And why is thy heart grieved? Am I not better to thee than 10 sons? This is the word of the Lord. We say thanks be to God. For better, for worse. The term for better, for worse is a traditional phrase often used in marriage. Vows to express commitment to spouses, to each other, regardless of the circumstances they face in their marriages. It signifies a promise to stand by one another through all of life's ups and downs, whether in times of prosperity or joys or in times of adversity or challenge. Today, we would like to examine some of factors that contribute to these failures, such as communication issues, unresolved conflicts, mistrust, among others, and some factors that help to enhance marriages. For example, forgiveness, trust, and respect. The story I read is very familiar. And we know about Hannah and Elkanah. Hannah and Elkanah, they were married for 10 long years. And Hannah had no children. So in spite of them being married, there were challenges. She had no children. Hannah's longing for a child is evident because she would go up to the temple and she would pray year by year. And she would cry unto God, asking God why. Why God? Why not God? Why can't I have a child? The inability, therefore, to fulfill society's expectation of bearing a child and of not being able to give her husband a child led to a lot of feeling of frustration for her. She was sad. She was always crying. Now, in today's society, we know what people say about women in a marriage who cannot have children. Some people, they make very rude comments, and we know the names that they normally call women who they claim is infertile. They call them mule, naso, barren, and all kinds of things. So she was in this situation. She was being called maybe not the names that we use nowadays, but as we read in the script, Penina would provoke her. That means in their language, Penina would call her names in their language and provoke her and laughed at her. There must have been emotional strain on the marriage. There must have been stress on the marriage. There must have been time when she felt like she would give up or walk away. However, commitment on her path allowed her to face the adversity, allowed her husband to love her unconditionally. So although there were issues, although they had problems, although she couldn't have any kids, and others were laughing at her, the problem in their relationship, Elkanah did not curse her out. Elkanah did not turn his back on her. He stood with her. And we see in verse 4, and when the time came and they went to offer sacrifice, he gave everybody else, but to Hannah, what he did, he gave a worthy portion. He gave her more. So that simply says that what was happening did not affect Elkanah. He never allowed it to bother him. He never allowed it to do anything to the relationship. He loved her even more. And for a man to give someone more of the sacrificial portion meant that she was close to his heart. In our situations today, sometimes we face situations and we love our spouse that we said, boy, he's close to my heart, or she's close to my heart. And I listen to many of you, how your spouse is close to you, and the endeavors, the different love words and all of that that you offer, which is very good. But sitting before me today are couples. And I ask you this question. How do you behave in times of adversity in your marriages? What is it that you do? Now, we saw what Elkanah did in times of trouble in his marriage, in his life. He loved her unconditionally. He was committed to her. So I ask you today, what is it that you do when you face these trials? So it brings me to the word commitment. I will not be very long because Rev is going to come with his fandangles. So what then is commitment? Commitment is a promise or a pledge to dedicate oneself to a particular person or a particular action or a goal or a devotion. Commitment means this is it. Nobody else. You and I, this is it. Commitment. You give up your all to the person or to whatever it is that you are making the commitment to. Amen? And so, we are going to look at a few results of commitment. One, commitment in marriage provides emotional security. When both persons are committed to each other in the relationship, it gives them a sense of security. Knowing that both partners are dedicated to each other through thick and thin creates a safe feeling and a stable environment where trust can develop. It gives you a sense of security knowing that the man or the woman is dear for you. It gives you a sense of security, saying that no matter what, if it's one person I can depend on, it's my husband or my wife. Commitment gives you that emotional security.
Yeah.
Emotional security in a marriage often refers to a feeling of safety and trust that partners experience. It's about feeling confident and being able to open to your spouse and to share the inner thoughts that you have. Things that you will not share with anybody else on earth. Me no hear no amen. Amen. Yes, man. I have things I tell Pastor that I will never tell anybody else in the whole world. Because I am committed to him. And I know I feel safe with him because he have me back.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So commitment provides emotional security. It allows the spouse to realize that no matter what, this person will not reject you. Yeah. And that is a good feeling. Yeah. It is a good feeling. Amen? Yeah. Amen. Commitment in a marriage gives long-term stability. Marriage is a lifelong journey. It's a lifelong journey. Commitment is what keeps the relationship steady through the good times and the challenging times. And we see that in the scripture I read with Elkanah and Hannah. She was going through a rough time, but he was there for her. It provides the assurance that both partners are in it for the long haul, willing to work through the difficulties and grow together. No matter what challenges come my way, I am in it and I will not give up. I am not going to allow anybody to come into my marriage.
Nobody
now come into my marriage.
Nobody.
It's my marriage. And that gives, because it's a long time journey. So we are starting it together. And so therefore, no matter what difficulties come in our bow, no matter what challenges come, we're not giving in. Because what? I made a vow. I made a promise. I made a pledge to this person, and I am going to go through. Comes what may, I am going to hold on to it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. You can't give up, no matter what the circumstances may come. You can't give in. You'll be tempted. Sometimes you feel like throwing in the towel, but commitment. Lord, I stood before the minister and I made this pledge. I am going to be committed to the end. To the end. Amen? Commitment in a marriage allows you to have shared goals and values. Shared goals and values. It fosters a shared sense of purpose and direction in the marriage. When both partners are committed to the relationship, they are more likely to align their goals and priorities, which strengthen their relationship. When you get married, you align your goal. You go into the marriage with your goals, your expectations. Your wife or your husband come to the marriage with his or her goals and expectations. However, commitment said, once you are married, you put them together. You align your goals with your partner's goals and say, look here, this is what we bring to the table. It is no longer I. It is now we are us. So you shared your goals together. The goal to buy a piece of land, for example. Now it, you had a goal to buy a piece of land over in St. Mary. And your husband had a goal to buy a piece of land in St. James. You will now have to sit and work out what is best for both of you. No, not because you come from St. Mary, you're going to say, Ade, me a go back. Me no business what you want to say. I don't say word. Or you say, boy, St. James, all of my family is, so we are going to build a St. James. Commitment say we sit and we come together and we share. Your goals become each other's. Your goal become my goal. And my goal become your goal. It is T-E-A-M. We put them together. Together we achieve more. So you don't go one side and do your thing. And then I go one side and do my thing. And the man can't say a word to you else to tell him what vain make him up. Because you are determined this is how you're going to do it. And no matter what, I saw me I do it. I'm in a business where you want to say. No. In a marriage, I know so it go. We put our heads together and align our ideas and our values and our goals together in order to make the marriage work. We must meet each other halfway, don't it? Yes, man. We have to meet each other halfway. Our values, what is it that we believe? We believe in honesty and we believe in dedication. No. These are some little things that may cause problems. For example, I put on a dress and all my glories are exposing. And my husband said to me, honey, that is too short. Me not take off, you know, because I feel me frock. That is not right. But we do it. No, you may not answer me today, but I don't business. I am going to share what I have in my head. Because reality of the thing, if we are going to be committed, no, you go and say, oh my God, is it too short? Let me change it.
Listen.
But some of us so stubborn and stiff naked, we not take off, you know?
True.
We not take off it.
True.
And the man is saying it because he sees what he's seeing and he knows that somebody else outside is going to see what he's seeing. So he's trying to fix you up.
Yes.
But because you're so stubborn and love the frack and wear the frack, you're not a coffee. Commitment say no. Commitment say values must be shared.
True.
Everything must be shared. If a man said to you, say frack too short, for God's sake, change the frack.
Yes, listen.
Or if she said, if the lady said to you, the pants too tight, for God's sake, find one different pants. So it's not one side, it's both. Because some of the men are headstrong too. Oh, Jesus, mercy. So therefore, commitment means we should both share values and our goals together. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, brethren.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Commitment in a marriage allows conflict resolution. Conflict resolution, problems are going to arise in the marriage. There will be challenges. Arguments going to come up. There will be disagreements, something that you have to see. Two different human beings coming together. You are going to have conflicts. It will come. There will be conflict over children, money, family members. All different kinds of issues will arise. And you will have conflict in your marriage. But when you are committed, you are going to what? Sit and work things out. Commitment encourages couples to address issues constructively rather than resorting to avoidance, avoiding the issue, you never talk about it, or giving up and say, look here, leave here, move on. But in your heart, you're begging. But because you can't bother you up a talking, you say, just leave it and move on. No. Commitment in a marriage says, resolve the issue constructively. Talk about it. Reach an agreement. So that you can move on. Some people will not budge, no matter what. They are not going to budge. It must be my way or the highway. Or it is my way or no way at all. In a marriage, commitment says no. You must compromise. When these differences are resolved in a marriage, the marriage gets stronger. When differences are resolved in a marriage, intimacy gets stronger. Harmony and peace will be in the marriage.
Yes.
There will be plenty of gifts,
yes.
Plenty of rose,
yes.
Plenty of honey, and a lot more
yes.
When we have resolved our issues. So when we have resolved our issues, we make up and your honey come, here's a rose. I'm sorry, baby. Here's a rose. I hurt your feelings.
Yes.
Nothing wrong with that.
True.
You feel nice, don't it? Yes, man. Talk to me now, man.
True.
Yes, man. Yes, man. I cook a very special meal. Try. You can know that he's trying to make up, you know. Can never do those things for a while. So you might try and make up now and do some nice little things that you never expect. But you just smile and say, thank you, honey. I appreciate it. Amen?
Amen?
Yes, man. When you commit it to each other, you try to make up. You must be creative in your makeup ways. Be creative.
Yes.
Not just sit down and say, all right, make me done with you. Oh, no, take it a little further. Sweet up the marriage, no, man.
Come on.
Yeah, man, sweet up the marriage, man.
Come on.
Go buy one little something, man, and say, Lord, me did hurt you, me put us, but here is something.
Come on.
Talk to me, man.
Yes, man, it's all yes, long I just eat and say thank you and go. No, man, put little spice night now. Yes, man, little honey and cinnamon in there too, all right? Yes, make it nice. So after we have resolved the issue, let's try to make it nice. Be peaceful, all right? It makes works. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And by the way, KFC, you can throw in there too, you know? Yes, man, you can throw 2 pieces of KFC in there.
And burger too.
Don't mention Burger King. Yes. And we don't know Burger King for months. I want to see the box and say, oh, yes, praise God, it's coming. All right. So resolving issues bring peace and harmony to the relationship once you have resolved it constructively. Amen. So nobody calling your mother and your sister and your brother and they carry business go to road. No bother with that man. Don't make the man feel shame when he walk on road because everybody know him business. No, don't bother with that. Let's do it nice and nice. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Church of God people, we are going on. Commitment in a marriage provides role modeling for children. Those of us who have children, it provides role modeling for children. A committed marriage provides a positive example for their offspring. Children learn valuable lessons about love and dedication and perseverance by watching their parents' commitment to each other. Commitment demonstrates healthy communication skill and a feeling for each other. Respect. So when the child goes on the street, the child learns how to show respect to other people because they have seen it being shown at their home between their parents. Showing mutual respect and consideration for each other's feeling and opinion sets a strong example on how children should treat others with kindness. Talk to your spouse properly, man. Now talk to him, man, like my little boy.
Come on now.
Show respect, na man.
Yes, man.
Not because he might be earning a little more. Come on.
True.
Or because he not going with nothing not going for him right now, and you want earning.
True.
In talk here, you're not even answer. I make him feel bad.
True.
And the children are watching.
True.
Talk to the man with little respect, man.
True.
And ladies. And gentlemen, talk to your wife with little respect, man.
Yes.
And don't treat your wife, if you had a wife before, don't use this, don't treat her like the second one.
Don't bring the past.
No. Treat them with respect. No, no macho.
True.
Parents plays a vital role in the development of their children. How you behave is how the children will behave in the public.
True.
So, if you talk to each other with respect and with love in your voice, they are going to do the same thing. So you have a responsibility to treat each other with respect in the presence of others, in the presence anywhere you go. So if you go downtown, God help me today,
talk up the things,
and the lady want one little money to buy one KFC, not till I forgot to buy chicken and rice and go home go cook.
Come on now.
Treat our man with a little respect, man. Yes, man. You know, think she tired to wash the plate and the house and everything. Yes, man. Treat her with a little respect, man.
Amen.
Hey, drive up, man, somewhere, man, or take taxi, go down there.
Of course.
I sit down and love up and make the fitness, you know, loving up, man, so that they have something to build their relationship when they get older.
Amen.
Amen.
Wow.
Amen. Yes, man. The hot wings, not true. Mercy, mercy. I tell you. Yes. Commitment allows you to apologize to your partner when you are wrong. It says we are so committed to the relationship that I know I hurt you. And so I am going to say I am sorry.
Yes.
You're not too big to tell a lady say you're sorry. And you're not too big to tell a man you're sorry. You're in a relationship together, so it should come easy.
Yes.
You hurt the partner, man. Say sorry, no man. Are you making stay there until you know hear she say anything I'm gonna and she forget it? No, man. I am sorry, honey. I hurt your feelings. Respect is due. Amen, guys. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Addressing disagreement calmly and apologizing when necessary, teach the children that they should maintain a healthy relationship. Help me, Lord. Please, uno don't fight before the children them. Uno drop no fist before the children them. I am asking you, please. If you have your disagreement, don't let your sons you slap your mother. You slap your wife. Or don't let them see you draping them up or doing anything that is necessary. No. Take it one side. Take it in the room. After they've gone to bed. No, if you want to tear off the roof, that's up to you. But don't allow the children to see you fighting. It is not good. And Christian couple fighting, are you lucky? You're tanned. Then drop some lick. I know because I've seen it. Yes, man, you think we easy? Yeah. Then drop some lick.
Strong lick too.
And the poor lady, she feel, you know, she's so embarrassed, she don't want nobody to see. All when it a kill her, she a smile.
Oh God.
So it is reality. Do not abuse your spouse. Commitment say, don't abuse your spouse. Whether verbally or physically or emotionally.
Do not.
Do not abuse your spouse. And some of us do it in such a dignified manner that we are abusing them and then not even realize that we abuse them. Oh, and then get so used to it that, honey, what you say? What you say, honey? Oh, Jesus, God. Have mercy. In the name of Jesus.
Stop it.
In the name of Jesus, stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it.
God is against it.
Repeat it again.
Stop it. If you're abusing your wife, stop it. God gave you your spouse as a helpmate, not for beating stick or cursing, whatever.
In the name of Jesus.
Stop it.
Oh God. My God. I love it.
Respect is due. Is who washing your clothes? Is who cooking your food?
Come on.
You know, I grew up in a community where I saw a gentleman mistreating this lady. She was always embarrassed. Right here was always swollen. Because it seemed like he was always hitting her in the face.
God, no.
What she did was wrong, but she was frustrated. And she would beat Miss, I don't want to call her name because we are online. She would beat Miss X left, right, and center. Poor lady.
Oh, God.
Sometimes she couldn't even come to church. Me talking about church people, you know, brethren. Right. It's church people we're talking about. So it's reality. And one day she couldn't take it any longer. When he hit her, she just take a frying pan and give him a clap. One lick with the frying pan here, so. She said, if you touch me again next time, it's cooking I'll be using. No, we don't want to drive our spouse over the edge, brethren. Let us not drive our spouse over the edge and let them have to do those things. It is not right in the sight of Almighty God.
Now I'll cut the things.
It is not right.
Oh my.
And we cannot judge them because we are not in their situation.
Yes.
We're not feeling, you say, he who feels it, what? Knows it. Yes. If you don't have on my shoes or burn me, you can't know if my shoes are burn me. Until you put on my burn toes, Sister Sandra. When you put on my burn shoes, then you will know. Not true.
True,
ma'am. So commitment said, resolve your issues constructively. Support your wife emotionally. Encourage them. Sometimes they may be feeling down, and women, as they get older, they go through certain phases in life. Husband, be supportive. And nobody get, oh, you just sweat like a hog, so Lord.
Sure.
No, it's a phase in life. Work with it, a man.
Oh,
yes, work with it. Amen.
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 Don't worry, we soon finish.
You're doing wonderful.
Commitment provides resilience.
Yes.
against challenges.
Yes.
Life, as I said earlier, is full of challenges, from financial setbacks to health issues and everything in between that. But commitment in marriage acts as a buffer against these challenges, empowering the individual when they face problems to know they have somebody to rest back on. It gives strength. They can draw strength from their partner. Lean on me. I am your rock. I am your partner. You're going through something, but I am here. Just rest back on me, no man. Physically speaking, rest back on me. Emotionally, I am there. I am standing firm and I am not moving because you belong to me. And I am there for you through thick and thin.
Amen.
You can rely on me with your eyes closed.
Amen.
Because I will never leave you nor forsake you.
Amen. Wow.
So when we are going through our challenges, don't go through challenges alone.
Oh, wow.
Don't shut out your partner.
Come on.
Allow them to help you along the way.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
They may not be able, they're not feeling the pain, but you can rest your head on them.
Praise God.
They can smooth your shoulder.
Yes.
Your foot is hurt, you know, they can rub your foot.
Massage,
that is
man.
What I'm talking about.
Yes.
Yes.
Support.
You are there for them.
Support.
Support them, man. Back them up.
Yes.
In situation.
Amen.
Thank you for that.
Amen.
For that. Back them up. Yes.
Amen.
Confirmation on my word.
It is. It
yeah.
is. Support.
Back them up, man. Support them.
Yes.
Let them know that you are there. But don't allow the lady to be suffering and you go on a road and you don't come in till 12 o'clock.
And watch TV.
Are you in the hall watching TV and the poor thing in a room has suffer?
Oh, God.
And you would have a PM no mind. Me can't help him because me can't feel the pain for him. But just rub it, rub our foot, no man. Rub our shoulder, no man. Give her a little water, no man. Even if she don't drink, he can't go put on, no man.
It means much.
And say, baby, he, me can't help you, but I am here for you.
It means much.
Eh? Yes, man. Support your partner, man. Be that rock that they can. The emotional strength is important, you know, brethren.
Very.
Yes, man.
Very.
When you know that somebody is there for you. Because, you know, we were talking the other day, and we were saying, you know, that retirement is a lonely road.
Oh, my God.
Very when you retire and go home, who you have? Your family. You know, nobody else. You know?
Only your wife.
Only
husband.
Your family and God.
Yes.
So if you're not there for your husband or your wife, then I have nobody.
And I trouble that man.
Because when you're up on a boat, you have your friend and you have this, but you see when you retire and go home, you and your husband one in the house. So you have to live good.
Amen.
You have to live good.
Amen.
So me sorry for you if you don't like see him anymore, but he's not going away.
Oh, amen.
You have to live good with him.
Hallelujah.
Because at the end of the day, he will be the only one there for you. The children, they have their own life. If it wasn't for Sienna, it would be me and Pastor alone because the boy didn't go about them business. You see what I talk about? Yes, man. So what if we weren't living good? God help me. After a while, so you must be there, give emotional support. And so they have somebody to rely on. They know that you will be there no matter what. This person will be there. Amen? Solid as a rock. Commitment says, in a marriage, provide flexibility.
Come on.
Flexibility. Yes. Being flexible and adaptable is important in a marriage. Because circumstances change. And so we have to work with circumstances as they change. It refers to the ability of both partners to adapt to changing situation, changing circumstances, and be there for each other. Now, you and I will never always be young and green. No, we will not always look how we look now. Flexibility. We are adapting to each other as we go along. So not because I am old now. You're going out, you're going to look at one sweet 16. The blood of Jesus against that.
Again, and the blood of Jesus.
We got married and we have been traveling the journey. Let's be flexible with each other. Changes occur over time, Sister Malawi. Yes.
Me not go slim and be 13 or 16 anymore. Me go get fat one at a time, put on little weight. Whether me fat or me slim, me belong to your love, me the same way.
Amen. Love me just the same.
Oh, praise God. Yeah. Yes. Flexibility, man. Yes, sister. Flexibility. When we got married, I could never fit in the dress that I got married in today. And pastor could have never go in a suit. But flexibility, in put on some weight around here, but me have more to hold. I look at it like that. So you work with what you have. Work according to what you have, man. Yes, man. Fix up your husband, man, or your wife. Look good, man. Make them look good. Yes, man.
Amen.
Wow. Yes, man. So be flexible with changes. Changes will occur in the marriage. You're going to look different after a period of time. So guess what? You rub up your face, man, and do your little thing, man, right?
Yes, man.
Flexibility occur also with illnesses. As we get older, different types of illnesses will come in. We never had high blood pressure before. Now we are getting older. It may occur.
Yes.
We didn't have diabetes before. Yes. But as we get older, that may occur.
Yes.
And there may be other illnesses that may come. Not because a wife is sick and you are not sick. Flexibility means that you're now going to start changing the meals.
Yes, ma'am.
Be flexible now,
yes,
man. Start cook different something,
yes,
to,
yes,
take care of your husband.
Amen.
Change the meal.
Amen.
You didn't love chicken one time, but my husband's sick, so me have to give it a little break.
God,
be flexible, man.
Yes.
Amen. Be flexible, man. And don't come and tempt him with the something where you know we kill him. Yeah? Yeah. If you got teeth and have it, you don't have a problem. You can't help if you teeth and have it. But you don't bite.
I love it.
You don't bite and give it to him, not you. Because some of them with teeth and eat it, you know that. Yes, man. Then take a little piece, like Oliver. Take a little piece. And then take a little piece till the whole thing done. Eh? Yeah. Boise. Yes. Boise. But now, flexibility says that if illnesses occur, there are certain changes that we need to make in order to allow our spouse to feel comfortable. We have to do what we have to do in order for them to fit through difficult times. Amen? So, couples, I say to you today, marriage is indeed a partnership. And as you know, it requires work. It takes time and effort. However, true commitment comes with the help of the Almighty God. True commitment comes like Ruth. Ruth said, yes, entreat me not to leave thee, nor to return from following after thee. Because what? Where you go, I will go. And where you lodge, I will lodge. Now, sir, your people shall be my people, and your God, my God. She was committed. But if you adopt a little of that in your marriage, it will work.
Yes. Amen.
Wherever you go, I am there with you. Whatever you do, I am there with you. Amen. It says, for better, for worse.
Yes.
Now, I am going to do a little demonstration here. I'm a teacher, so you expect that. All right. So, please help me, Bishop. Hold on. This says female. Now, this is a female by herself. You notice the color. It means she has her own habits. She has her own behavior. Her own intention. This is who she is. With all the behaviors and the habits and whatever she is. This is marriage. And marriage is empty. There's nothing not going there yet. So, the female marriage. Please pour for me, Rev. Not all of it, some of it.
Okay.
Go ahead. All right, stop. Thank you. So the female, we see the female, right? We see the female. Now this is the male. The male also has his habits, his behaviors, his challenges, everything. So they meet each other, don't it? Yeah. So you have your behavior and your challenge. Now the man has his own. He has his own behaviors. He has his own attitude and whatever. Poor family pastor.
Mix them up, man. Say work out, you know. Oh, Lord.
Stop. So this is marriage.
Two become one.
This is marriage. It's a mixture of feelings,
yes,
emotions,
yes,
challenges,
yes,
attitude.
Yes.
You bring yours and him bring for him in it.
Yes.
So after all that I have said, how are you going to make this work? It is only God. God is what we'll have to invite into this situation. This is the situation. And we have all kind of things inside of it. But how is it going to work? Only the Holy Spirit of Almighty God will make this work. Poor pastor.
Yes.
Oh, bless the Lord. The Holy Spirit says, call on me and I will be there for you. In your good times and in your bad times, I will be there for you. Look unto the hills from whence cometh your help. My help comes from the Almighty God. He is going to work. When you face your challenges, call on God. And God will come true. Poor family pastor.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Oh,
this is your change. When you invite the Holy Spirit into your marriage. When you invite God into your marriage. When you give God everything. This is what happens. There is change in a marriage. There is change in a marriage. Because he's there to support you. He's there to guide you. All the situation will change. Because the Holy Spirit is in the marriage. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit in the marriage. So you will not be able to make a commitment to your wife. And a commitment to your husband. I said to you, Glendevon, trust God in your marriage. Fight for your marriage with the help of the Holy Spirit. Fight for your marriage. Do not give up on your partner. No matter what you may be going through, fight on, because God has your back and will. He will come true for you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
Hey.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, 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 hey.
Glory, glory, glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Come on, couples. Fight for your marriage. It may be rough. It may be tough. But you have to fight for your marriage. The devil is like a roaring lion going about. But you have got to fight for your marriage. Put your hands together for the speaker. My.
Oh, wow. Oh, glory to God.
Yeah, Lord. Hallelujah. Don't give up. Don't give up. And for those of you, you may be wavering right now. Fight for your spouse. Fight for your husband. Fight for your wife. In Jesus' name. My God. My God.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, we bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Don't. Today is a special day.
Amen. Praise God.
I don't know. But my life is challenged. My marriage is challenged.
Yes.
And I know I would have loved my wife for many years. But I will continue to love her.
Even more.
Even more.
Yes.
For her commitment.
Yes.
to the marriage. Because things happen.
Yes, ma'am.
Challenges we face.
Yes.
But she stands beside me.
Yes.
And decides not to leave me. And I can tell you that today it is better. To God be the glory. I'm gonna invite the couples to come to the altar, please.
Hallelujah.
The couples. You are here as a couple. Stand beside your partner. Hold your partner hand. Come. I'm trying to. I don't want you to turn your back to the altar. Turn around. Yeah, turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Yes, no, face like that. Face, yes. Yes. Okay, no, it's good. Yeah, yes. But you have to. Let me see. Just move that bench for me, please. Yes.
Thank
you. Yes, just push on that. Just push it back a little bit. Yes. Give them some more space. Yes, go. Yes, go on. No, you can't turn it back. You have to face your partner. Yes, you have to. Yes, yes, yes. Face your partner. Yes. You have to turn around and face your partner. Yes. Give them some space. Go along some more, Brother Leslie. Go along to the bench. Yes. Right. Spread out. Yes. Yes. But don't go too close. Just, yes, to each other. Yes. Turn around and face your partner. Turn around and face her. Yes. All right. Okay. Beautiful. All right. Everybody, facing each other. Brother and Sister Green. All right. Face each other. Oh, it's... You can come right up, Brother Green. Yes, 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 yes. Come right, come. Beautiful. All right, brother, they are coming. Yes. All right. Brother and Sister Reed, they are here. Now they will come. All the couple. No, that Brother Reed is here.
Yes,
brother. Where is Brother Reed? Where's Sister Reed? She's around the back. Okay, Carla from that. She's needed. Yes, Carla. Okay. Come, Brother Reed, please come. Okay. Brother. And if that bench can go down some, I want some. If that bench can even go down some more, the second one, Brother Green, just push it a little. Just a little closer. Yes. Yes, beautiful. Make some space at the altar. You can come, sister. You can just go a little bit. Yes, just go a little bit out. Yes, just, yes. Look at me. Yes, just go that way. Yes, yes, beautiful. Yes, yes, yes. We want to see. She's here. Come on, put your hands together for Sister Reed, everybody. I hope the space is. Today is a special day. Today, we gather to celebrate. We celebrate divine institution of marriage, in which a man and a woman commit themselves to be husband and wife. We celebrate the previous commitment that you would have made with each other, probably months or many years ago. We celebrate God's graciousness and enabling power that has made this day possible. And we celebrate the continuing commitment of vow renewal that we have the privilege as family and friends to witness. I say to you today, probably months ago or years ago,
you stood before a minister and pledged yourself before God to the commitment of marriage, regardless of the challenges that would have come your way. There is no doubt that your steadfast commitment to Christ and each other has brought you to this special day. More than likely, you have overcome many difficulties in your private and public life that others may have considered to be too great. Not only have you proved them wrong, but you have demonstrated that a husband and a wife in harmony in Christ can accomplish great things. Amen. When you previously shared your vows, there was anticipation of the future. More than likely, you had dreams and hope for the years ahead. The same is true today. Only now you have a foundation of memories and experience as well. You understand to a far greater degree the effort, the give and the take necessary to have a loving and fulfilling marriage. Husbands, you are going to answer me. I will. Look at your wife. Look right into her beautiful eyes. Oh, Lord, they are still shining. Yeah. Will you, this is for the husband, will you continue to have the wonderful woman that you are holding as your lawful wedded wife and spiritual partner in Christ? Will you allow your love for her to grow in the years ahead? Will you comfort her in sorrow and care for her in illness? Will you laugh in her times of happiness and hold her close in times of tragedy? Will you guard your heart and keep yourself to her only as long as you both shall live? Answer, I will. Men. I don't hear the men. Okay. Wife, look right into I will. Wife, will you continue to honor your husband as your lawful wedded husband and spiritual partner in Christ? Will you allow your love for him to grow in the years ahead? Will you comfort him in sorrow and care for him in illness? Will you laugh with him in times of happiness and hold him close in times of tragedy? Will you guard your heart and keep yourself to him only as long as you both shall live? Answer, I will. Beautiful. Husband, please repeat after me. Look right into your spouse's eyes again. All right? Say after me. As a personal commitment to you and a public statement before our family and friends, I renew our wedding vows. I take you again to be my wife in the bonds of holy matrimony. I pledge to be your friend, your lover, your partner, in whatever circumstances of life that come our way, in health or sickness, in happiness or sorrow, I will love and cherish you until death us do part. Beautiful. It's now time for the wives. Wow. Wives, say after me, please. As a personal commitment to you, my husband, and a public statement before our family and friends, I renew our wedding vows. I take you again to be my husband in the bonds of holy matrimony. I pledge to be your friend, your lover, your partner, in whatever circumstances of life come our way. In health or sickness, in happiness or sorrow, I will love and cherish you until death us do part. Oh Lord, let me just say, okay? Inasmuch as the husbands and wife today have committed themselves in marriage many years ago and declare their continuing commitment to each other before God and these witnesses, we affirm their union as husband and wife. We commit them for the life of commitment and prayer for the next 5, 10, 15, 50 years as the Lord would have it to be, for better, for worse, and for every wonderful blessings, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. You may kiss each other. Did you catch it? Them say you must do it again. Okay, after 3, 1, 2, 3. Oh Lord. I tell you, man. All right, watch. I'm going to pray. But you never catch me? Yes. All right. Sister Roper didn't catch everybody. And she wants to catch everybody. After 3, 1, 2, 3. Beautiful. Before I pray, come on, describe that kiss.
It was yummy.
We didn't get that.
It was yummy.
It was yummy. Okay, Brother Green and Mr. and Mrs. Green. Okay, Brother Bennett and Sister Bennett, describe that kiss, Brother Bennett. Oh boy, he can't explain it, but I believe it was wonderful. Put your hands together for the couples. Beautiful. God bless you. Could you bow your heads at this time? Could you hold your partner's hands? Hallelujah. 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 What a friend. Hallelujah. We have in Jesus all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. We thank you, God, for this day. It's a wonderful day that you have given unto us, O God, to celebrate. We are celebrating, oh God, Couples Sunday. Many years ago, or months ago, God, you have joined us together in holy matrimony. We thank thee for your grace. We thank thee for the mercies. And we thank thee for your love. Many, God, would have gone through great challenges, God. But here they are, standing at this altar, renewing their commitment to each other. I pray for a special blessing over every couple right now. I ask your God to bind them together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind them together with love. Let your peace, let your grace, let there be commitment, God, understanding, God, and everything that they need, God, for the marriage, oh God, to continue for years to come. I pray, God, you will supply them right now. In spite of their differences, in spite of the difficulties, Holy Ghost, I will ask you to release yourself right now in every marriage, because I know when you release yourself in marriages, God, though problems may be there, but though difficulties may be there, they will be kept together. I bless the couple right now in the name of the Father. I bless them now in the name of the Son. I bless them in the name of the Holy Ghost. And I decree and declare, God, that no weapon that form against them shall prosper. And every tongue that rise up against them in judgment shall be confounded. In the name of Jesus, when sickness comes, when poverties come, when distress, oh God, will come, stand beside them, God, and grant them breakthrough, financial breakthrough, and every breakthrough that they need right now, I decree and declare it over them, God, in Jesus' name and for Jesus' sake. Let the couple say hallelujah. Let the couple say hallelujah. Hallelujah! Glory to God! Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. In Jesus, hallelujah. Clap your hands for Jesus, somebody. Hallelujah. You may go back to your seat with your spouse in your arms, smiling. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Ah, hallelujah. They put back the benches together. Just worship your God. Just worship the King of Kings. Our heart has indicted a good matter. Hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Oh, what a lovely day. What a lovely. Hallelujah. What a lovely moment. Ah, God is good. God is great. We love him. We love him. We love him today and forever. He is always. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Wow, wow. And we all say, wow. Come on, bring out the wow.
Wow.
Awesome. Aren't you feeling loved today? To God be the glory. I could never let this miss me, don't it? I appreciate the audience. You just sit still. You're just attentive. I love it. Clap yourself. Clap yourselves. And the single ones, boy, I like this. No one get married to. Sister girl, you want to get married again? Oh, beautiful. To God be the glory. Put your hands together for Lady Lewis. Marvelous job. Wonderful job. Whole heap of food for thought. Whole heap. I hope you take notes, you know, because I have mine. So we go home and chew upon them, eh? Beautiful. What do you have to say, love?
Oh, what a word.
Amen.
What a word.
What a word, amen.
And it's reality. It goes for all of us.
Amen.
And I even make some little jottings where commitment is concerned, provide emotionally, Security, emotional security, long-term stability, keep the relationship steady. Challenges is going to come. But no matter what circumstance, don't give up. Values, honesty, trust, respect, understanding, forgiveness. You can you can name it. Amen. Learn to apologize.
Amen.
So I was listening keenly, Rev, and thank you. Thank you for the word. Oh, what a word. At this moment, my wife is going to minister in song.
But before we do, can I ask my helper please to bring that portrait thing there, please, thank you. Please to ensure it's coming, that before you, she's coming, auntie, thanks. That's all right, thank you. I want to ensure, please, hold it up, let them see. What does it say? To have and to hold. So all the couples going to do is just put your face together with a kiss, or I don't know how you're going to do it. And make sure you take a peek before you leave. Yes. You like what you see?
Yes.
Beautiful. Wonderful. No, when we are finished, thank you. And at this time, may I ask all the couples, once you're a couple, please stand. This is for us.
Yes.
Please stand. Brother Rose, oh Lord, that's all right, a father indeed.
Amen.
All right, hold on to your spouse's hands and just think of these words as I sing it for us. Praise God. So many nights I sit by my window waiting for someone to sing me a song. So many dreams I've kept deep inside me, alone in the dark, and you've come along, and you light up my life. You gave me hope to carry on. You light up my days and fill my night with a song. Lonely at sea, adrift on the water, wouldn't it be finally to sing you this song? Finally, a chance to say, hey, I love you, and never again we be all alone, and you light up my life. You gave me hope to carry on. You light a song, and you light up my life. You gave me hope to carry on. You light up my days and night with a song, with a
you, love.
Embrace your spouse and have a seat. Embrace your spouse and have a seat. Sister Sandra, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Oh, we're coming down nicely, beautifully. And at this time, we have our couple's moment, and we have a few little giveaways. Let me hope. All right. We would have thinking about, of course, the youngest couple. I don't want to believe that the youngest couple is not here. Am I correct? The youngest couple of the congregation. It would have been... Right. Fine. All right. I have a visitor couple in the house. Could you stand, sir, madam? Sir, madam, please remind me your married name again. Bennett. It's nice to have you in the house, Mr. and Mrs. Bennett. Nice to have you, sir, looking lovely. Please grace your wife with a, you know.
Amen.
Yeah. Wow. Do you care to share, sir? How long have you been married? Oh, Lord. Did you hear that? Please repeat again, sir.
Oh, 19.
So, how much is that? 50? Oh. Oh, Lord. Do the math. Do the math. It would be 52. Am I correct? 52. Put your hands together for these two beautiful, and you have been through hell and back, don't it? But today, you're reigning. To God be the glory. Can I ask you to fetch him a bottle of wine? Yes, sir. And everybody say, wow.
He came all
the way from St. Catherine. Wow. Wow. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Church, say hallelujah. This is God. And so, sir, on the behalf of the Glendevon New Testament Church of God, the pastor and the membership at large, our couples ministry, we present to you that bottle of wine. Do enjoy it. The Lord bless you. Bless you. Thank you. Most welcome. All right. We have, of course, another newest couple in the house. Two of them, rather. Mr. and Mrs. Green, please come. Where is Mr. and Mrs. Green? We also have Mr. and Mrs. Wright, of course. They are newly married, don't it? Yeah, in our congregation. Come on, please stand. And it is my privilege to present to you this token of our love and appreciation to Mr. Wright. And Mr. Wright will know what to do with it. Also, to Mr. and Mrs. Green, I present to you, sir, for both. Thank you, sir, madam. And of course, can I ask my helpers, please, to bless this couple with a bottle of wine. Begin with my pastors first. May hope, say, if you don't get none, don't come for me. Don't come for me, but I hope I have enough. So, when you're going to give, just, once you get about, just come on out and just present it with love. Okay, sir. You're not going drunk, sir. Mr. and Mrs. Freighter. Beautiful. Mr. and Mr. Weatherburn, Mistress and Mr. Nice. Take your partner out. Get yourself together. Line up yourself. Mr. and Mr. Malahu. Smith. Okay. No problem. Is it Smith? Allen. I must get it right. Mr. and Mrs. Allen, please come. Followed by Mr. and Mrs. Cox. Come on, cheer the couples. Aren't they looking lovely? They really, really come out. They really come out. Looking beautiful. Mr. and Mrs. Fraser, when they are through. Keep the cheers going. Thank you for taking the time out to be in our couples ministry. Come on. Beautiful. Come on. Followed by Mr. and Mrs. Rose. Beautiful. Mr. and Mrs. Leslie after. Mm-hmm. Followed. Beautiful. Mr. and Mrs. Cox. Sorry, Scott. Scott, yes. Followed by Mr. and Mrs. Rowe. Look at the beauty. Look at the couples them. Look how they're looking beautiful. Wow. I love it. Wow. Come up, Mama. Hey, Sister Scott. I ramp with Sister Scott in a jizam. Bosaki says Sister Scott. Sister Scott, no, shut up behind that. What's a kiss to no man, from Brother Rocky, no man? Whoa! Beautiful.
Followed by Sister Ro and Brother Ro.
The Rose.
The Rose.
They are all in a row.
The Rose.
Come on.
Princess Black.
Where we are now? Where we at? Mr. and Mrs. Williams. Come on, keep it going. I mean, Brother Willie. Of course. May I ask, please?
Thomas.
Okay, Mr. and Mrs. Thomas, please come. Yes. Followed by Mr. and Mrs. Ricketts. Mr. and Mrs. Wright, Mr. and Mrs. Mel, Bell, Mr. and Mrs. Bell. Mr. and Mrs. Bennett. We have another one, sir. Thanks.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. Go ahead. Go ahead. It's your day, your time. Okay. Okay. Brother and sister, may not, but you can't reach. I'll take it to you. That's fine. I'll take it to you. And Mr. and Mrs. Reed, yes, I'll take it. You have to do two more rapping. That's fine. Do I leave out anybody else? Sister Donna, where is Sister Donna? What is her Sister Nana? Next year, this time, of course. Put your hands together for all the couples in the house. Oh, bless the Lord. It's our pleasure and privilege to allow you to feel loved. Wow. I was waiting for it, man. That's that's a word you're leaving out of here with today. And every time you look at your husband or your wife, wow. And so that Bible marker that you have, please write your name on it. Mr. and Miss, just write Mr. and Mrs. Whether Johnson, Philip, whatever. Yeah. All right. All right. And I have taken care of this, the ladies. Yeah, those who are married and they have deceased. Yeah, you're loved. Stand all these beautiful ladies here. Please stand. Please stand in the house. Yeah, you want us a bride. But unfortunately, yeah, your husband is not here, but you are here. And you continue to walk the walk and live the talk. Put your hands together for these beautiful ladies. Yes. Yes. God bless you. We also have Sister Ayat. I know for sure if Brother Ayat was here, man, big up yourself, sister, and give love. When you call on the phone, say, honey, wow. Sister, meet over there. Yes, man. Big up yourself and give your husband the wow. Yes.
And all the ladies stand a while ago. But Brother Plummer, could you stand, sir?
Good.
Yes. We have to appreciate Brother Plummer as well.
Yes.
His wife is, you know, deceased. So, Brother Plummer, big up yourself. Oh, big up yourself.
Put your hands together. Beautiful. Did I leave any stone untouched? Children, family members, friends, visiting ones, it was a delight having you in our audience today. Wow, sir. It's your time, sir.
Lord, to God be the glory. I don't have anything else to say. It has, wow. Sister, where the burner's given us something to go with, wow. So when everything is okay, just say, wow. God bless you. Could you please stand, everybody?
A second, sir.
I want to thank.
Hold it, sir. Do the closing remarks, but I never allow my spouse, my co-host, to say something, sir. I have to say something, sir.
Okay, all right.
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Wow. Yes, sir. So my encouragement to all the men in the church, take care of your wife.
That's right.
Love your wife. Support your wife. Support your wife. It is very important. Even though sometimes, you know, the challenges, the thick and thin and the whatsoever, but love your wife. As my pastor said, Sister Lois, fight for your marriage. So if situation is there, fight for your marriage. I beg of you, I beseech of you, brothers, just love your wife. fight for your marriage.
Well said. Put your hands together for Brother
Paul. Beautiful, beautiful.
And I use this privilege to thank Sister Malahu and Sister Bowen. Put your hands together for them. Part of the planning committee would have met, would have come up with such a wonderful plan. And to God be the glory. I thank the moderator, and I thank everybody who would have come out here today, would have made this couple Sunday of such great success. I don't know if I'm going to be here for next year, but if I am here, we look forward for another couple's Sunday. God bless you. And I make one announcement. The last Sunday of this month will be Scout Sunday. So some scouts will be coming to worship with us. I think from the 18th through the 26th hours will be Scout Week. And we are going to be the host of some scouts. Amen. And we are looking forward for that day, the 25th, the last Sunday of this month. Let us look forward to having them in Jesus' name. Father, I commend this olive oil into your hands. I pray your mighty blessings upon it right now. Your daughter, God, has confidence, God, in prayer. That if we pray over it, God, and she uses it, God, miracles will take place. And so I bless this olive oil. I sanctify it, God. When she uses it, God, allow healing power to flow through her body in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost. Shall we all say? Amen. The Lord, could you please stand up if you are sitting? And just raise your right hand to God as we pronounce the benediction. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and be gracious unto thee and give thee peace. Henceforth and forevermore shall we all say,
amen.
All right, just before, don't leave. Please be seated, please. Please be seated just one more second.
And just when you go home, please remember to watch the service again and share the link with your family members and friends.
Immediately after we are through, quick two announcements. Sister Lewis would like to meet the members of the Executive Women's Ministry. You know yourself. Just a quick talk. Sister Malo, would you like to? You have anything you want to say? Close off quickly. After that, we have cake and ice cream for the couples. Also, we have a closeout song for the couple, please. Let's do the thing starting to finish. And so just sit in the audience. Remember the bridegroom, the bride, and the bridal party go first before the guests. So please be, come, Sister Malo, quick, and then.
To God be the glory, great things he has done. Brethren, how are you feeling today? How are you feeling? I am feeling well, special and elated. And today we have an awesome time in God. Brethren, God no make mistake. And when God speaking people, let me no make mistake. And if they follow the directive, building on the firm foundation, it will accomplish great wonders. Don't you believe that? Amen. Wonderful. So, wonderful. I just want to say to all those who came out, all the couples, my brothers and sisters, and for the visiting couples, thank you for coming. Thank you for coming to allow this couple's day to be one with a difference. For all our sisters and brothers who were married and your husband may pass, or they are not here, I want to thank you too for coming out. And you're coming here, allow today to be an awesome one. And we thank God for you. For the lovers on top here who moderate the service and go on, I just sit back and let them get way. Yeah. You know that. Yeah. But to God be the glory. Yeah. It was awesome. It was very good. God, no make no mistake. Oh, God, my pastor wife gone. But I want to tell you, God is indeed an awesome God. Yeah. And we thank her for that wonderful word of encouragement to boot us up and to turn us around. Let us think a little on some things that we have dropped and left out. You understand, brethren? Yeah. So let us just pick up that and move on. Remember, ladies, remember the convention coming up Wednesday. Couples ministry meeting will be. We are not sure yet, but we'll announce it. We'll announce the couples ministry meeting that we can plan other things that we can accomplish. Get in your ideas, ours, and we put them together to have a vibrant couples ministry. So ladies and gentlemen, when we call you, don't pull back. Come on out and let us have an awesome time in the Lord. There are some team, you know, where you got to sit down and listen to, you know. Sure. Hey, I don't go there. Back it up and let us wait until that very moment. When we call you guys out, then we can have a wonderful time in the Lord. Take care and thanks very much again. Have yourself an awesome and a wonderful afternoon.
Amen. Amen. Wow. All right, Minister, take it away. Couples, please stand.
And remember, ice cream and cake is provided.
Third time, couples. Hold on.
Somebody loves you back.
Making it trust so come on, people.
To be loved and be loved in return. It's the only thing that my heart desires. Just appreciate the little things I do. Oh, you're the one who's got me inspired. Keep on lifting me higher.